Hello, everybody, and welcome to the future.
If you speak a word of what I'm about to show you, you will be executed for high treason.
It's beautiful. It's the greatest encryption device in history, and the Germans use it for all communications.
Everyone thinks Enigma is unbreakable.
Let me try, and we'll know for sure.
Today's video is about The Imitation Game. Tonight, we went in to see The Imitation Game, and we loved it. It was about Alan Turing, the true story about Alan Turing, who helped decipher the Enigma code during World War II, and later on became prosecuted for homosexuality.
The movie stars the following actors:
Benedict Cumberbatch,
Keira Knightley,
Matthew Good,
and the guy from Game of Thrones.
So it's a really great cast and with great acting. We really like the movie so much that right now is 3 a.m. in the morning, and we wanted to have this video made today and release it as soon as possible. We're sure that you're gonna love this movie. Something I really liked about the movie is how they play with the times in the history, the flashbacks, the future, and the present time. They really built up the characters. At the beginning, when I was seeing the movie, I didn't understand all the flashbacks, but at the very end, you see how they make sense and they put together this other story inside of the movie. When I saw the trailer, I thought it was gonna be, you know, a bunch of guys trying to break this code. But the movie actually is focused in the life of Alan Turing, and it draws into you that you forget about the war, but you focus in the life and everything that he's going through in the movie, and not only him, but the other characters as well.
I really liked Benedict Cumberbatch's performance. When I had seen the trailer and I was actually looking forward for this movie, I knew it was going to be amazing.
Yes.
Because we've seen him in Sherlock, and he just knows how to act. He does a brilliant performance. And in this one, he does a sort of like Sheldon Cooper.
Yes.
Kind of a deal, no? Where he's super intelligent, but doesn't really know how to get along with the public. When they make jokes or whatever references, he doesn't get them, and then he questions them. But throughout the movie, there are a lot of funny moments.
Yes, a lot.
I was surprised because it's not obviously not a comedy,
yes.
But there were many moments where we all just started laughing out loud in the cinema and everyone else around us. It was the little quick remarks and the little wits in the dialogue. Like, for example, somebody takes his sandwich away and he's like, hey, that's my sandwich. And then he's like, but you said you don't eat sandwiches. And then, you know, it's these little types of things that make it funny. So it's not so serious, the whole movie. Yeah. Wilbur, ¿qué te pareció la peli?
Increíble, una de las mejores que haya visto desde que salieron las últimas, desde la última que vi, que fue La Teoría de Todo. Benedict hizo un gran trabajo interpretando a Alan. Los rostros, la expresión facial, fue una de las mejores. Las escenas con la cachetada, uff, te quedas así de wow. La reacción de Keira, no la había visto actuar de esta manera. A mí, cuando la veo, siempre me recuerdo Pirates of the Caribbean, Elizabeth Swann.
Sí, la actuación de Keira es así como que la tienes encasillada, ¿no? Piensas en ella y dices, ah, Piratas del Caribe. Y en esta película nos muestra otro lado, ¿no? Que ya es más que Piratas del Caribe, que tiene más que aportar. El actor principal, Cumberbatch, mis respetos. O sea, sabemos que una vez que él está en el cast, va a ser un buen logro. Creo que todos los personajes aportaron algo excelente para la película. Creo que una de mis escenas favoritas es casi al cierre de la película, cuando él se abre con John y le explica lo solitario que él está por todo lo que está pasando, que está haciendo, que el juicio que está teniendo de ser castrado químicamente y todo lo que está pasando, pero eso no le preocupa tanto como abandonar su creación, algo que le recuerda tal vez al primer amor de su vida, y él está dispuesto a pasar todo esto con tal de no perder, ¿no?, a Christopher. En este, pienso que esas y las expresiones que tiene te transmite a través de la pantalla. A mí me llegó y dije, oh, voy a llorar. Me aguanté como los hombres, no lloré, pero sí está.
For me, one of my favorite scenes, it's a powerful scene. It's the moment where they realize that they have cracked the code and they're about to tell the commander, that they did it.
Ah, yes.
But then Alan has the notion that if they suddenly move and attack the Germans will immediately think
they
cracked the Enigma code and they change it, and then it's 2 years of work just out the window, and then they'd have to start again, and already the machine, you know, costs so much and a lot of man hours went to that. When they find out that they can't tell anybody about it, this is when we find out that one of the members, he says that his brother is on one of the convoys in one of the ships. So this is a very hard and crucial moment where they realize that they can't tell anyone and they have to let his brother die and the hundreds of others of women and children and families die just for the greater good to win the war. I mean, they're not here to save 500 people or 1,000. They're here to save the entire world from the Nazis.
Yeah, but and they did, but it's a huge sacrifice.
It is a huge sacrifice.
What do you think about it? It's, you know, my friend's family, and you have to make that choice, and you have to live with it.
Right.
Basically, they have to decide who's gonna live and who's gonna die.
Yeah.
Playing God. The ending scene was pretty surprising. I was not expecting for him to die or kill himself. I mean, such a brilliant mathematician, brilliant mind. I think he could have done so much more. But I guess from the chemical castration and the pain and the judgment from him being a homosexual, I guess it was just too much for him. But even then, he wasn't quite normal, you know. He was an introvert, an outsider, so all this, and he was alone.
Yeah.
So all this may have affected him so much that he just decided
to end his life.
Like, what else is there to do?
Yeah, I mean, there were different times, you know, the 50s, but even, you know, chemical castration, that's really cruel, you know, really cruel punishment. And you can understand, it was his secret, you know, his secret life, and it was like a crime. He was, you know, being gay, it was a crime, so he couldn't tell anybody. And we were talking about how all these beautiful minds that we see in the movies, they're all always introverts, they're alone, and they're suffering a battle within themselves. So that, I think that's something that you have to understand when you're seeing this movie, you know. Maybe you cannot relate with a character.
He was a war hero.
Yes.
And all the punishment he received, all the pain, making a war hero commit suicide. That's a big thing.
See in the end how it says, because with his help cracking the Enigma code, they reduced the war by 2 years.
Wow.
And spared 14 million lives.
Even today, the calculation that you use on computers are based on his mathematics. You know, most of the algorithms we use today are based on his research and his studies.
We're all watching this video right now through a screen, a computer, whether it's your cell phone or computer or tablet. You know, it's all computers, and it all dates back to Alan Turing and his algorithms, being a mathematician and all.
Is it good? The screenplay, good. Actors, good.
Good, really good.
Everything excellent.
That was it. It's a great, great movie.
Great movie.
So yeah, guys, this was a review for the Enigma Code. Awesome movie. If you have the opportunity to see it,
go and watch.
Yes, go see it.
We absolutely recommend it.
Yes, and thank you for a lot of your support to our little project. We hope you really liked it. And what are your comments about the movie? What did you like? What you didn't like? Let us know. And if there's a movie you would like us to review in the future, the comments below.
Thank you for watching. We are Amateur Film Reviews. My name is Nick.
My name is Wilbur.
Abdiel.
Nos veremos en el futuro.
Hello everybody and welcome to the future.
Nos veremos en el futuro.